My name is Ken Wilson. I'm a professor of evolutionary ecology at Lancaster University, and I'm particularly interested in the interactions between parasites and their host, and in particular insects. And my favourite insect is this guy here, the African armyworm, Spidoptera exempta. And I've been working on this insect for about 20 years now. And what we've been trying to do over the last few years is to try to understand the natural interaction between the African armyworm, a major crop pest throughout sub-Saharan Africa, and its natural disease, a baculovirus called SPEX-MPV, also known as Spidoptera exempta nucleopolyhedrosis virus. That's why we call it SPEX-MPV, much easier to say. It's December 21st, everyone's getting ready for Christmas, and I'm on my way to the airport to catch a flight to Zambia to assess the food security crisis caused by armyworms.
Got a busy couple of days ahead of me. What I'm hoping to do is to visit some farmers who've been affected by armyworm, assess the impact on food security. I'm going to collect some armyworm samples to take back to the UK for analysis. And if all goes to plan, I hope to meet with the Vice President of the country to discuss the armyworm situation and what could be done about it going forward and the role that biopesticides might play in the future. It's about 20 hours flying time to Zambia, so 20 hours there, 20 hours back, and just 33 hours in the country, so effectively a day and a half to do some work.
Well, I've just arrived in Lusaka. It's pouring with rain outside. Pretty wet and miserable, but being the tropics, I'm sure the rain will go pretty soon, and hopefully we'll be able to get out and do some field work. We're going to go out into the villages and see what damage the armyworm has caused. On our way here, we've already seen some damage caused to pasture grasses, and it's been pretty devastating.
We had a lot of them. Just anywhere you see them.
The armyworm.
Yeah, the armyworm.
So Donald, tell us about this area.
Basically, this whole land was green, but the outbreak of these armyworms, basically, they're amazing grazers, and they've turned the whole land, which was green, to almost bare, which is now the way it is looking now, you know, bare brown really. And these are just remnants, because if you had come 4 or 5 days ago when it was all green, really they were like all the leaves are just covered by these armyworms. Yeah.
Where armyworm have attacked. One armyworm was not so quite so lucky. Well, this is what the crop should look like. Next door, however, it's not so good.
This is Annie Matutu. This is her field. Tell us what you've done with your field.
So this field, it was affected with the armyworm. So what we did, we buy cypermethrin, then we sprayed all the round of the field, and we dig a trench all the round of the field, then we started spraying in the evening. We sprayed the trench so that the armyworm can't move into our field to destroy our maize. So you can see this field is looking nicely. because we sprayed.
And is the chemical costly?
Chemical?
Yeah.
It's cypermethrin.
And yeah. It cost a lot of money?
It was 150,000 2 liters.
Treated with chemicals. Not treated with chemicals. That's all damage caused by armyworm.
Can you show the armyworm? Plate infested with armyworm collected by the children. You got some armyworm as well.
Yeah.
You come in. Everyone in.
Okay, so this is Donald, my assistant, who is carefully picking out pupae of African armyworm, so we can take them back to the UK for scientific analysis. So it's 8:40 p.m. I arrived in Zambia God knows how many hours ago. Start again. It's 7 o'clock in the morning. I've been here for 24 hours and I'm just off to go and see the Vice President to discuss the armyworm situation and what can be done for it going forward. Exciting.
So that was a very good meeting with the Vice President of Zambia and his staff. We discussed the armyworm crisis and the things that can be done going forward. And we also discussed the use of MPV as a biological control agent for African armyworms. And the Vice President and his team are very keen to do some trials in Zambia with a view to having MPV available as a biological control agent against armyworm next time they attack. It's good to see the research paying dividends.
I'm here, God knows how many hours since leaving. Arrived safe and sound. Unfortunately, the same can't be said for my bag, which apparently is still stuck in South Africa, together with all the samples I collected. So it's going to be a little while yet before I can start analysing those data. Still, Christmas now. Well, as you can see, I got back home safely. Christmas is upon us. It's a late afternoon on Christmas Eve. My armyworm samples are still in my suitcase somewhere over the Sahara Desert. But it's been an inspirational trip. Visiting Mrs. Matutu to see the efforts that she's going to try to protect her crops, her livelihood, her family's food from armyworm. At the moment using conventional pesticides, but who knows, in a few years' time, hopefully
available to her would be Specs MPV, the biopesticide we're working on. Meeting Dr. Scott, the Vice President of Zambia, was also inspirational, and the efforts that his country are doing to try to combat the armyworms in these very unusual times. And it was encouraging to see the level of interest, that high level, at national level, in the work that we're doing. And again, hopefully we'll have something available for his country to use next time armyworm attack. It's been a very long weekend, over 10,000 miles, nearly 40 hours of flying, but I'm back home now in the comfort of my home, and it's time to forget about armyworm and to move on to thinking about Christmas, to get into the Christmas spirit, to think the Christmas spirit, and maybe to have a mince pie or two.